Hey guys,
my name is Kriyanche and welcome to episode 7 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. This video will be dedicated to a viewer suggestion that I got on my channel, which is on how to implement logistics pipes with fluid transposers from thermal expansion. So let's get started. So as you can see, first of all, I'm in a little bit of a different world. I will be doing things in more specific worlds from now on instead of the massive world that I had before, just so I can specifically pinpoint what you will need to actually do this. So let's get started. So first of all, like any logistics pipe system, we got ourselves a logistics power junction right here, supplying power to the actual logistics pipe network. Then on the other side, we got ourselves a logistics RF power provider, because I might as well, make use of the episode that I got where I talked about how you can transfer power like a redstone flux through logistics pipes through machines. So that's pretty useful. So then again, some basic pipes, unrouted pipes, more basic pipes right here. Then on this side, I got myself a logistics Jesse pipe Mark V and a satellite pipe. How I got this all set up, I will talk about in a minute. Then right here, I got myself a logistics chassis pipe with an item sink and a provider module. This chest is pretty much only to act as a storage chest, so that's pretty useful. And then I got myself a request logistics pipe, so we can actually request items from, you know, what you want to autocraft using the fluid transposer. Pretty cool. So then let's quickly talk about what I actually got set up here. So, first of all, to actually power these two machines, which are the Magma Crucible and the Fluid Transposer, I got myself the Thermal Expansion Power Supplier upgrades in both of them. Then, of course, in the middle right here, a Power Transportation upgrade, and one on this one too, because I need to send power over to these machines. Then, on the back of these machines, I configured them both to be the inputs on the back, and this one also to be the output to the right, which is, of course, for the fluids. Then the fluid transposer is set to input from the left, which is the Magma Crucible, input from the back, which is the network, and then it has to have any of the other three sites to be output, just so that this logistics pipe network can recognize that it is allowed to take items out by itself. Pretty useful. Then on the satellite pipe, which I talked about how it works, pretty much you configure an ID on this for things that require more than one machine to craft, so I set this to satellite ID 1. And then in the actual chassis pipe, I configured two recipes. The first one being one empty redstone engine flux duct plus two redstone in the satellite pipe, which is the Magma Crucible, will give you one redstone energy flux duct, because pretty much you will need 200 millibuckets of molten redstone and you get 100 per redstone, so this is the recipe for that. And then on the other module, I configured it to be a little bit different. Due to the fact that if you want to melt up glowstone, you get not 100 but 250 millibuckets per dust, and one item duct, if you want to craft an impulse item duct, only requires 200. So I configured the recipe to say 5 item ducts and 4 glowstone. So that's 5 times 200 is 1 bucket's worth of molten glowstone. And of course, for glowstone dust, when melted, also gives a full bucket, so, you know, these have to make a bit of sense. We'll give you 5 impulse item dots. Pretty cool. So, yeah, that's pretty much all that's needed to actually autocraft with fluid transposers and a magma crucible. But of course, I quickly demonstrate how it will work for you guys. So in this chest, I got myself redstone energy flux ducts, the empty versions, and some redstone. And of course, some glowstone and the item ducts themselves. Simply right-click with a wrench on a request logistics pipe, or otherwise you can also, of course, use the remote requester if that's something you want to do from a distance. Then you can see what you want to craft. Let's quickly set it to only show the craftable items. So let's say I want 10 redstone energy flux ducts. Okay, request successful. As you can see, power is flowing too. It has sent 20 redstone dust into the magma crucible. The magma crucible is outputting the redstone into the fluid transposer, which got the redstone energy flux ducts, the empty ones, and it's automatically being filled. And due to one of these sides having the output, it doesn't have to be the back one, by the way, it will know, okay, I'm able to extract the redstone energy flux ducts, and it's being sent into the chest right here. Note that I already had one in there, so that's why I currently had 11. Pretty awesome. But then you might again ask, like, okay, for the other recipe, you configured it to give you 5. What happens when I only want, like, 2? Well, this system is kind of smart with it. So if I want to, for example, request 2, it will fulfill the fill recipe to give you 5 of them. So that is 4 glowstone dust and 5 empty item ducts. But only one of them will be sent into this chest, or 2 of them. I requested 2, of course. 2 of them will be sent into the chest, and the other ones will be dumped into your network for later requesting. If I want to, say, request the other 3, it can simply do it from the network and it will no longer have to craft it. That is pretty useful, and of course you can say not just the fluid transposer, but the Stingwell has a lot of potential in other contraptions around your world, so that is, in my opinion, pretty awesome if you're fond of logistics pipes, just like me. So like always, be sure to leave a rating if that's something you like to do, always appreciates me. And of course, a little bit of feedback down below helps me motivate it, make more content for you guys. And of course, if you have anything specifically you want to see, either with logistics pipes, applied in logistics, or any of the other 250 plus mods that I play on, and trust me, I play with a lot of mods and know a lot about them, so don't be scared to ask. Just let me know in the bottom, in the description, or you can always find me on my own dedicated IRC channel, which is Priyanjay at Esprinet. So like always, thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.